Hello everyone and welcome to episode 3 of Amusement Insider's Business Banter. I'm your host Jasmine, and today I have 3 awesome new topics to bring to you guys for discussion. So let's start with our first topic of the day, parking pricing increases at Disney and Universal. What's going on here? In recent episodes we talked about ticketing pricing increases, and now we're seeing the same in parking pricing as well. What's happening with the industry and why are we seeing so many pricing increases? So this news has actually been around for a few weeks at this point, but I wanted to hold off on our discussion around it because we had those investment calls happening with Cedar Fair and with Six Flags, so we wanted to talk about those first and foremost, but I don't want to leave this topic behind. So today I wanted to discuss those recent increases that we've seen to the pricing at Disney and Universal. So in about mid-October, Disney raised their parking prices to $25 for standard parking and $50 for preferred parking. Around the same time, we also saw Universal hiking their prices to that same $25 price point for standard parking, and they only went as far as $40 for preferred parking, but it's still a significant price increase. And I know to some longtime Disney resort goers, there was also a little bit of an upset because Disney announced that they would now be charging anywhere from $13 to $24 per night for parking at their resorts, which is kind of unheard of for Disney. Usually it's kind of a package experience when you go to one of their resorts, so to see that we're now being charged such significant prices for parking as well is a pretty big change for people who are used to their previous norm. These price increases and additional charges are raising many questions for park guests and industry experts alike. I mean, how sustainable are these increases as a solution to an industry-wide revenue problem? Guests simply won't continue to fork out more and more money for parking spaces over the coming years. We definitely will begin to see an uptick in private companies profiting off of park guests' needs to save money. From Uber and Lyft to taxis and buses, it's likely that we'll see guests turning to alternative and more affordable ways to get to these parks. So I want to know, what will you do as these prices continue to increase? How do you feel about Disney and Universal using parking cost increases to supplement lost revenues in other areas? This also opens up a lot of other questions. Like, how can megaparks like these continue to improve their pricing systems for parking and ticketing in general? How can parks innovate in the area of parking needs? And specifically for Disney, what do you think Walt Disney himself would think about all of this happening? I know he was the king of Imagineering and of thinking outside of the box, and I know when I hear about issues like this, things like People Mover and monorails come to mind, and Disney was always looking to innovate and make things convenient and easy for people, and also cost effective for both the guests and the parks. As the ultimate Imagineer, what do you think his opinion would be on this, and what do you think his solution might be? So please share your thoughts down below, and as you do so, I'm gonna move on to topic number 2. So topic 2 today is Legacy Entertainment's rebranding. This is also news that's a few weeks old, so bear with me if you've already heard about this one, but I did want to just open up discussion about it. And for those who aren't super familiar with how theme parks and the entertainment industry works, I just wanted to introduce you to companies like this that exist, because I know a lot of people don't really think about this side of things. So when visiting a new theme park or entertainment attraction around the world, have you ever stopped to wonder who designed this impressive, crazy, immersive experience? You know, how did this get to be here? And how did it all come to life? Well, Legacy Entertainment is one of the companies responsible for designing and creating such awesome works of design, art, architecture, and engineering. An industry contender for 16 years now, Legacy Entertainment has designed and launched over 40 successful entertainment projects around the world, including the Studio City and Galaxy Resorts in Macau, China, as well as the Georgia Aquarium, and many other theme parks, water parks, resorts, Broadway shows, and more. If you've ever attended IAPA or IAAPA, which for those who don't know is an amusement industry conference of sorts that happens on a yearly basis, you may have seen Legacy Entertainment or other design firms present at the events and booths and conferences. Now with that said, it's going to be really exciting to see what Legacy Entertainment brings to IAPA this year, because they just finished a rebranding, which is actually the first rebranding in their history, so it's a real milestone for this company. So why is this a big deal for the industry? Because we see all of this change happening all around us. There are parks that are expanding, there are parks that are changing up their models. We see lots of huge change happening in the industry in general right now, and companies like this are going to be a huge driving force in how that actually physically shows up in your experience. So definitely look out for Legacy Entertainment at IAPA 2018, which, by the way, is happening November 12th through 16th, so we will be discussing that in future episodes and what kind of announcements and excitement we hear from IAPA this year. And I would love to hear your thoughts down below. Did you even know that companies like this existed? I know many people know that Disney has their own Imagineering department and research department, but not all parks and not all attractions do. So did you know about companies like this? What are some others that you know about and would like to hear a little bit about? And do let me know if there are any other parts of the experience creation aspect of the entertainment and amusement industry that you'd like to know more about. Is there anything that you're curious about? Any things that you don't know how they are created or how they come to be? Let me know in the comments down below, because we'd love to talk more about these kinds of things in the future. So this brings us to our final topic of the day. Disney's budget cuts and research investments. We're kind of seeing a duality here in what Disney is doing with their budgets and their funding right now. So in recent months, we've seen lots of budget cuts specifically to Animal Kingdom, following a spat of low attendance overall in their parks going into the fall. So even though Animal Kingdom has been recently beating out Epcot in terms of attendance, we are seeing lower attendance overall in their parks. So with that in mind, they've made some budget cuts, but it's interesting that they chose to make the budget cuts to Animal Kingdom instead of Epcot. So some of those cuts that we're seeing at Animal Kingdom is Rivers of Light is actually downsizing, and they're cutting all live actors in the shows, and that's been happening since September. In addition to that, we're also seeing Kilimanjaro Safaris cutting their evening route and closing as early as 6:30 p.m. this month in November. So with the sort of flip-flopping that we're seeing at Animal Kingdom, how do you think guests are going to react to that? People are just getting used to having these evening attractions available, and they've been getting really great reactions, and now all of a sudden they're being taken away, and it's something that guests may not understand the reasons why. So how do you think people are going to react to that, and how do you feel about it? So with those budget cuts happening, it's been really interesting to see over the past year or so Disney actually investing a lot of money in different research, technologies, and even patents. This is that duality that I was mentioning, where we're seeing cuts in some areas, but increases in spending in other areas, specifically in the area of research and development. So with that said, Disney Research recently published a report on a new in-painting technology that allows a system to automatically imprint a costume or outfit onto a photo of a person. So this is sort of a pseudo-augmented reality type of experience that will allow guests to have a photo taken and immediately see themselves in a costume in the photo. So just imagine a little girl having a photo taken of her at Magic Kingdom in her regular everyday park clothes and immediately seeing that photo print out with her wearing a beautiful Disney princess's dress. It's just like magic, right? So I know technologies like this have existed for a while. We've definitely seen it in the past with systems like the Microsoft Kinect, but Disney Research developments are really taking this technology to a whole new level. Now with that said, earlier this year, Disney also came up with a new conductive paint technology, which is really cool and can actually make any painted surface a completely interactive experience. In addition to that, they are also working on technologies over this past year that can go into clothing, such as like a jacket or a vest, that will allow you to feel sensations that accompany what could be happening in a virtual reality environment around you. So picture you having your virtual reality mask on or in some kind of immersive ride or attraction experience and actually feeling on your body the impacts of what could be happening in that experience. For those of you who have already experienced virtual reality, you know how immersive that experience can already feel. Now imagine feeling the sensations actually on your body as well. It really brings you into a whole new world, and it's really cool that Disney is looking into these types of technologies. So let's take a second and look at all of these different areas of research and development from the past year as a whole. When you look at the photo technology of actually, you know, putting clothes on you immediately in a digital world, then we look at the paint technology that we're using and the clothing technology, it's kind of creating an overall picture of how Disney is researching virtual reality and virtual systems and augmented reality, and really looking into what technology can potentially bring into their parks and into their experiences. It seems to me like Disney is gearing up to introduce virtual reality on a level and on a scale that we've never seen before. So definitely share your thoughts in the comments down below. Where do you see Disney taking these new technological advancements? What kind of attractions and rides do you see these being used in the future? And is it something that you think guests will respond well to? Is it something guests actually want? And is it something you actually want? Are you excited to see this kind of technology being researched and potentially entering in a more prominent way in the theme park industry? We've seen many flops, both with VR on roller coasters and different attractions and rides of different sorts. We've seen it tried in different ways, but what do you think Disney's about to do with this technology? Because Disney is known for going big or going home. And following those questions, my final curiosity with this is, you know, with all of this in mind, do you think that the budget cuts we just discussed at Disney Parks are in preparation to invest in these new technologies in their parks instead? So are we simply seeing a shift in investments here? Are they removing old school attractions and expansions that they've done in the past in order to make way in the budget and in the parks for these new attractions and inventions and investments coming in? What do you think? Share your thoughts with us in the comments down below. I'd love to hear them. So that's it for our business banter for today. Let me know what you think down below. I can't wait to hear everybody's thoughts and opinions. And if you have any suggestions for future episodes, again, please share. We're happy to hear them. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next week.